Mr. Drew, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at a question that you may see maybe towards the end of your homework in an Algebra 2 or pre-calculus book. And this type of question today actually was a question, a problem that a lot of my kids did not initially figure out. So we talked about it today after they finished their homework, and I'm going to pass this on to you. The problem said, write the height of h as a function of x. So we have a region on an xy axis. We have a horizontal line that is connecting segment that's connecting the points of 2, 3, and 4, 3. And we have an orange rectangle. We're not concerned about the width of this rectangle. It's just really so that I can point to this, and on the camera you can see what I'm looking at. We're going to be finding the height of that rectangle. And it's going to be the height between this parabola, y is equal to negative x squared plus 6x plus 5, and the horizontal line segment, basically of y is equal to 3, specifically looking at the segment between 2, 3 and 4, 3. A lot of students were not sure what to write for this problem. Well, first of all, writing the function height as a function of x means that we should be thinking of, or another translation of this is writing h in terms of x. Or in other words, the end of this problem is going to have some kind of, you know, variable of h and then equals and some other stuff going on over there. And there's going to be some stuff on the right hand side, probably involving some algebraic, mathematical looking stuff, some work to do, but the only variable that's allowed on the right hand side of the equal sign is the variable of, well, x. And again, this was a question that a vast majority of my students in my class were not able to understand. So what I did was I asked them some questions that were a little bit easier. Understand that we have a graph, which is a parabola, and a horizontal line, and I'm looking for a vertical distance. You find vertical distances and actually horizontal distances all the time when you calculate slope. The slope of a line is the change in y or delta y over the change in x or delta x, or y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So when I gave them a couple of functions which yielded constant values, like maybe we've got a line of f of x or y is equal to 4, and g of x, let's actually put this up here, g of x is equal to 1. When I drew a horizontal line of y is equal to 4 and a horizontal line of x is equal to 1, they were very confident that no matter where I drew a vertical line, whether it was above the x value of 4, whether it was above the x value of 6 or 7, or indeed anywhere that I drew a vertical line segment, or maybe a rectangle, they all told me that the height of that rectangle was equal to 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3. And that was fantastic. If you can answer this question and see that the vertical distance between the line y equals 4 and y equals 1 maintains a constant distance of 3, then you actually know how to answer this question fundamentally. And by the way, it doesn't matter if your equations are both above the x-axis or below. So let me put one line. If I give us a line of y is equal to 5, or in function notation, maybe f of x is equal to 5, and another equation of, say, g of x is equal to negative 3, or effectively another equation of y is equal to negative 3, you know that how to calculate a change in y, how to calculate a vertical distance, is some y value maybe coming from one function and some y value coming from another function. Only when we deal with slopes, we're just looking at numbers that are coming from a function, numerical y values, that vertical distance is going to be, if you want that distance to be positive, which would kind of make sense in terms of distance, there's no such thing as a negative distance, you would do sort of like the large y minus the little y. The large y that's coming from the function that is above or on top, so that is going to be a value of 5, and then minus that, I'm getting ahead of myself, minus that, the y value that you're getting from the lower function, the function that is giving you the smaller y value. So large y minus little y, or 5 minus negative 3, is going to give us a vertical line segment, a change in y of, well, equal to 8. So hopefully that's good with using constants to identify the distance between two functions, or just subtracting the two y values. And my class was very confident in all of their answers. And then moving on to our actual question, I went one step further of giving them an example of constants, and I said, what is the distance between the top of this parabola and the line? And in this case, because this isn't exactly the same that's in the book, and I have this on graph paper, the top of this parabola, our maximum y value, we have a relative max, actually an absolute max of 4, and the bottom of this line segment is coming down to 3, and so the length of that red line segment is 1. But when it says write the height, the distance between the parabola and the line as a function of x, what that means is I want a function, I want an equation. If you ignore the equal sign, I want an expression where I can plug in the x value of 3 and get a distance. And at the same time, at the very next second, I plug in a value of 3.25 and I get a distance. A value of 3.5 and I get a distance. I want a function. I want something that I can just plug in a value of x and out spits a value of y, or a distance between the parabola and the line. So we're not going to be able to say it's just 5 minus negative 3 and it's 8, or it's 4 minus 3 and it's 1. I want to do that mental arithmetic in terms of function notation, in terms of variables. And that height is variable. That red line is longer than that green line, which is longer than that green line, and so on and so on. Well, what was the 5 in this example? It was the y value that we got from the function. Where was the negative 3? The y value we got from the other function. That red line was 1 because of 4 minus 3, the y from the parabola, and the y from the line, y is equal to 3. I want to be able to find that height by doing the large y value that we're getting from the parabola and the small y value that we're getting from the equation of the line. I'm calling this big y and little y because literally when you move up the y axis you get larger numbers. And I want to do that by plugging in a value of x, but I don't want just some random value, some random coordinate of x, y somewhere out in the middle of space. No, we want our coordinate to be on the parabola, which means that's not just a generic coordinate of x and y, it's we get to choose the x, the independent variable, but the y coordinate, the dependent variable, the dependent value is coming from the parabola. If we just say x, y, that's just a point in space. But if I say x, comma, and then for y, replace it with negative x squared plus 6x minus 5, now that is a specific y value that is actually on the parabola. That's what that means. So in terms of a general distance, I think I want to do this in, I'll keep it in green, hopefully it's showing up well on the camera. What is the length, what is the height, what is the vertical distance between the parabola and the line? Well, that parabola is going to give us all different kind of y values, and that large y value is coming from the expression of negative x squared plus 6x minus 5. And the small y value is coming from the line, which this is going to look a lot simpler. That line y equals 3 is giving us a constant y value of 3. And that is the expression, that is the equation, that is the function of h, negative x squared plus 6x minus 8, that is describing the variable height, variable distance, between the parabola and the line, y is equal to 3, or this lower line segment connecting 2, 3, and 4, 3. And that is the answer to the question. Now, if I come in with maybe the color red and I come up with a second example, maybe instead of the line being below the parabola, I put a line above the parabola, maybe at 6. And I'm looking at this region. What would be that variable distance between the line y equals 6 and the parabola? Again, still y is equal to negative x squared plus 6x minus 5. What is that vertical distance? Well, it's big Y or Y sub 2 minus little y, Y sub 1. Big Y moving up the y-axis, having a value of 6, minus the y value is not any generic xy, but the y value that we got from the parabola using whatever, some x value that's between 2 and 3 is going to be negative x squared plus 6x minus 5. And so in this example number 2, our h would be distributing the negative. We're looking at x squared, negative times negative, negative 6x, and then negative times negative is positive, and we have 6 plus 5 is equal to 11. Why is this style a question where you're finding the vertical distance between two functions in your pre-calculus book? We'll cut the word pre off and you're in calculus, and at least in the textbooks that I teach from in my school, it is chapter 7 where we start talking about finding volumes of solids using disk method, where we take these two-dimensional regions on the xy axis and we rotate them around an axis and create a volume of revolution, and it's called the disk method. So if you want to see an application of this finding a vertical height between two functions, you can look up, and I'll put a link in the description, finding volume using disk and washer method. And that is the end of my example. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go to your homework.